Can you please introduce yourself?
Hi, my name is Nims. I'm a tattoo artist. 8-9 years back, I started tattooing because I wanted to get heavily tattooed. And I realized that tattooing was extremely expensive. To tattoo my leg at that time, I wanted something like, you know, a big tattoo on my leg. And I just realized that it wasn't going to work out, and a tattoo machine was much cheaper than the actual tattoo. So I was like, okay, I'm going to buy a tattoo machine. I bought a cheap Chinese tattoo machine. I started tattooing apples and melons, and I just wanted to learn, yeah. YouTube, that's how I was learning. I got really lucky. Andy in Anjuna, he decided to take me as an apprentice. He saw my work, my art actually, not my tattooing. And he thought there was something in me. Then I moved to Goa for 4 years. That was a really life-changing experience because he's a very professional tattoo artist. So he was earning a whole lot of money. And I realized that you could be a professional tattoo artist in India. Before that, I just wanted to tattoo myself and my friends. So, and I was still doing something else as career. This was going to be my hobby. In those 3-4 years in Goa, my perspective on tattooing changed and my look changed. I became very heavily tattooed. I saw so many people tattooed. I wanted tattoos in my life. Then 3 years back, I had a baby. That completely changed my life. I couldn't support the Goa lifestyle, or mentally I didn't want the Goa lifestyle. So then I came back to Delhi. I set up this tattoo studio in my dad's house. This used to be the living room. So I was never normal. I didn't want to be caught up with the normal kids in school. I wanted counterculture. My jeans were ripped when we were in school, right? I wore big fat baggies. I spiked my hair before anybody else. I wanted to be up there. I had a lot of beads. You know, if you're not confining, chances are you'll get a tattoo. Because it's part of that culture. You see it in the movies, you see it in... You want to connect to the rappers or do you want to connect to the businessmen? That's, I'll say, like, who are you? The girls that I was dating had tattoos. The guys that I was chilling with had tattoos. All the people on motorcycles had tattoos. I wanted to be accepted into this world. And this world had tattoos. So that's what kind of made me want to get tattooed. Or not a small tattoo, heavily tattooed. When you want to be a certain amount tattooed and very visible tattoos, that's a different mind frame. I'm definitely from that mind frame. For Indians, it's hard to take our clothes off anyways. But you go to Goa and everybody's in there, as a guy at least, everybody's in their boxer shorts. You'll take your shirt off at least. It's hot as well, right? When you walk around, you'll feel naked. You'll feel that feeling. This is the feeling I got when I was 21 years old and I went to Goa for the first time. I was a cool kid in my own bracket of things, but when I went to Goa, I was nobody. And I already had one small tattoo at the back, but it didn't make me feel like it was clothing. Today, I feel like my tattoos are like armor, like clothing. It's more on the customer, what style of business they want for it to succeed, let's say. If people are more ready to Google and find me, then more people like me can exist. And if people just want to go to the mall and get tattooed, then people like me will start going and working in the mall. If the customer can't care to find me, then I have to be somewhere that he can see me. At the moment, my customer is on Facebook, is spending some time trying to look for what are the other options available for tattooing, and so they're finding me. So I'd say it's where the money lies.